Good evening and welcome to Central High School. Knighettes in the process of taking on the Lady Cats here in the district tournament. This is semifinal action. I'm Aaron Murray alongside with Carter Southern coming into this game just a few minutes late. We're at the 6:20 mark here in the first quarter. Knighettes up 2-1 thanks to a couple of free throws by Caitlin Gillum that were sent just a few minutes before we were able to get on here with you all. Thank you for joining us here on Black Knight Television or the FHS Night Vision YouTube channel. Lady Cats inbound the ball. And of course, the big story of the night for the Lady Cats will definitely be whether or not they will be able to repeat what they were able to do in the conference tournament. Of course, the Knighettes being upset in that tournament. They received the one seed in that tournament just as they did in the district tournament. Coming in as the one seed once again. Fredericktown coming in as the four once again. So their second place finish in the conference tournament didn't do a ton to help them seeding-wise, but definitely was a boost to their confidence. So far, Knighettes not able to put a field goal in so far, and we're just past the two-minute mark. Williams charges down and ends that run. Knighettes able to put their first field goal with leading scorer, all-time leading scorer at Farmington High School, Rachel Williams.
Williams going to be a big threat in this game, like she is almost every game. Definitely broken a lot of records so far this season as well. Should be interesting how she matches up today.
Big three-point shot there by the one that's done all the damage, Tara Helm, in and out. And Williams goes down on the other side of the court and puts a couple in herself. It'll definitely be interesting to see what the Knighettes are able to do tonight. As I said just a second ago, losing the last time they faced the Fredericktown Lady Cats in the conference tournament. And, of course, most of that coming from Helm. Helm scoring 23 points in the last matchup against Farmington. And right now the Lady Cats trying to work the Knighettes defense. A shot up, and it's off the back of the rim. Rebound by Martin. Ends up being fumbled around and ends up in the arms of Caitlin Gillum, who scored the first 2 points of the game. Martin with a three-point shot, no good off the rim. Bader with the rebound, the putback, no good once again. Unable to get her feet set, and instead just throws up a prayer there, not answered. Off the backboard, rebounded by the Lady Cats, tries to split a couple defenders. Defenders straight up, but still get the foul call. Well, the foul call that time will be on it's number 11, Shania Sweeney. That's our second foul already, and we're just underneath the halfway point of the first quarter. First free throw shot from the line for the Lady Cats. No good. Lady Cats only sinking one free throw so far. 6-1, your score. Second free throw shot. Up and in. So the Lady Cats, 50% from the line so far. And that one coming from number 12 of the Lady Cats, Nicole Burns. And Lady Cats coming back down the other side of the court, misses the layup, gets the putback opportunity, and instead another foul ends up being committed by the Knighettes. That's already the fourth foul by the Knighettes. Burns will be back at the line once again, sinking one of two just a second ago. Her first is up and no good off the back, off the front. And Lady Cats so far not shooting very well from the line once again. 6-2 the score. Second shot up and in by Burns.
Foul that was made by number 20, Alexis Pauls. He was a freshman for the Knighettes. Pretty impressive start for just being the age that she is, coming up on Farmington varsity and doing what she did. Obviously not a good start of the game for her.
Gillum with the ball for the Knighettes, gets it in to Williams. Williams back out to Gillum. Gillum looking over to Martin. Martin has a little bit of an open look, instead gets it over to Pauls. Pauls scrambles around, tries to bring it in, and draws the foul. And that's by the same person who has been at the line back-to-back times here, Nicole Burns. So that will be her first foul, second team foul at the 3:54 mark now. Ball is inbounded to Gillum. Knighettes doing quite a bit of movement on the perimeter, and that time the young Pauls called for traveling. Carter, you got the chance to see a little bit of Fredericktown towards the end of their game against the Central Lady Rebels during the conference tournament. Were you able to catch Fredericktown any other point this season?
Not too much, honestly. A lot of the boys I saw against us.
And, of course, the boys ended up losing last night in their quarterfinal matchup. They ended up dropping the game to Potosi. Potosi, a team who was unable to win a single conference game this season, ends up pulling off the win in districts. So definitely interesting storyline there, as the Knights will be set to take on Potosi on Thursday night. And, of course, hoping that they will win that one. And most likely, they could end up being a Farmington Central girls and boys night Friday night here at Central High School. For a district title on both sides. Ball stolen away. Fredericktown gets a little bit of a look, but Williams there defensively to keep Fredericktown from being able to score the easy breakaway bucket. Shot up, no good. Rebounded back by the Lady Cats, and so far, Lady Cats here in the first quarter unable to sink a field goal. A deep three-point shot off the front of the rim. No good. Rebounded by Gillum. Gillum down court.
Starting to notice early in the game that a problem in this game is probably going to be boxing out. You can already tell too many offensive rebounds are going to happen, and that's not a good way to set off the game.
Jordan Martin with a three-point shot. First three-point shot of the game. Jordan made a lot of noise last year shooting from three range. It's been pretty quiet this season, though, and it will be pretty important if the Knightheads expect to have success beyond the district tournament, where they will most likely meet up with Dexter, who is a very, very strong girls team this year. If Jordan Martin can get hot and match that with the talent inside with Williams, Knightheads could be a very dangerous team. Lady Cats able to put their first points on the board finally from the anywhere except the free throw line.
Great pass by Pauls in the number 44 for the Knighettes hands.
Bader's able to put some points on the board once again. And right now, Knighettes spreading the scoring around a little bit. Williams with 6, Bader with 2, Martin with 3. Shot up and no good. And Caitlin Gillum with 2 from the free throw line as well. So 13 points. For the Knightettes, Williams leading, of course, with 6. Another jumper there by Williams, and a nice job to be able to break the defense up to go to 8 points by herself. 15-5 to score, just over a minute left here in the first. Carter, I'll definitely say that Farmington has forced several outside shots, several bad shots by Fredericktown. And last time these two teams matched up, Farmington was able to get a sizable lead heading into the third quarter, and it would be there in the fourth quarter that Fredericktown was able to make a big comeback to end up with that victory in the conference tournament. Ball scrambled around, a poor shot taken that time by number 5, Paige Gotze. Just kind of threw the ball up after receiving the rebound, didn't take the time to put a good form together. Knights end up with a rebound, and they are fouled by number 31, Tara Helm. That's already 2 fouls by the leader, Helm. As I said earlier, Helm, 23 points in the conference matchup against the Knights.
Knights might have to stay hot this game with all that rebounding that the Lady Cats are bringing on them. You can't hold back too much of that for too long, and your shots aren't going to fall like they normally are. For the beginning of the game, you can only stay hot for so long before, you know, rebounds start happening, the easy shots get put up. Not much you can stop with that.
And just now, another turnover by Pauls. That's 2 real quick here by Pauls in a couple of possessions. And a foul across there. Looked like it might have been a foul by Williams. Instead, she has called for the travel before the foul. So with 7.8 seconds left on the clock, Knightettes will try to do something here on the inbounds to get one last shot thrown up. and possibly extend this 10-point lead. Gillum with the ball, 5 seconds on the clock. Tries to throw it down court. Stolen away by Fredericktown, and they are unable to get the shot off. So Knighttes tried to scramble down court, unable to do so. After one quarter of play, though, Knighttes up 15-5 on the Lady Cats.
Kind of glad you're back with us here, Mr. Murray.
Huh?
I don't know how I'd fill up the time here.
As you have found out, along with several others, sometimes filling in the gaps every now and then on some of these games isn't the easiest thing, but I tell you what.
Verbing my ABCs or something, yeah. That might entertain them.
You go back through the games this year for the Farmington Knighttes, though, there is quite a bit to talk about. Of course, you go back to the first game that the Knighttes and Lady Cats played. Knighttes dominated the matchup throughout the night, ended up winning by 21 points. And in that game, the senior Tara Helm, who's kind of became the leader for the Fredericktown Lady Cats, she was only able to score 9 points on that night and then turned around and scored 23 in that conference tournament. And, of course, these Knighttes were not too happy after that game. We got Jordan Martin that I talked to several times during the day about the games from one game to the next, and she definitely was not too happy with the results in that game, and still a little bit of a sore subject. Hopefully after tonight it'll no longer be that way.
No, she makes sure that anybody that talks bad about her gets an earful.
That's true, but
she's
definitely a competitor. She enjoys coming out here and playing some hard ball. Knighttes trying to put some more points on the board, scrambled around, rebounded by Jordan Martin. Martin scribbles off to the side, a little bit of a smile because she collided with Gillum. And Jordan was trying to take the ball out, but instead got stopped by Gillum and couldn't get away from her. Pauls with the ball, throws it out on top. Knighttes working the perimeter once again. Martin with another 3-point, pumps the fist. And nice job there by Jordan Martin. Hasn't been too many games this season where we've been able to see her sink multiple threes. Nice to see two here in the first half so far.
Martin definitely with the potential. I don't know what it's been with this season. Hasn't been what we normally saw like last year.
Well, she started off really rough at the beginning of the year, and it seemed like after starting off that way at the very beginning, she was never able to really recover. But hopefully here in the district tournament, she can get a little bit of confidence. Pauls this time with a 3-point shot. It's no good. Bader fumbled around the rebound.
Well, it's a little difficult to get back up after a slump. Normally the shots aren't ever the same, just coming from somebody that has played basketball. Not saying that I, get out there too often. But it's definitely different whenever you don't feel that same way on your shot, and that's probably what she's been feeling at the beginning of the season. Good to see that shot's been coming back now.
Well, I promise I'm not trying to pick on you at all, but remember a game about a week ago.
Good Lord. No, we can keep talking about something else.
End of the JV game. I think you would know how to define a slump after trying to put some points in there at the end of the game on that one. And constantly, you were right there on the mark, just slightly off of it.
Back rim, man.
Back rim.
It's like Six Flags rim at our schools, I guess.
I'm not sure how many times you hit the back rim. I'm pretty sure it was around 5-6 times that you were trying to.
No, we don't need any numbers.
You tried to put the – you were getting pretty good looks. Getting decent space, but
no, we can talk about something else.
Well, as you're saying, that's kind of the same attitude that Martin had early on in the school year with her 3-point shots. They were about the same thing. There wasn't too often that she was missing, and she wasn't going out there and airballing every single one of them. She was just slightly off the mark and just couldn't put it together. But so far in this game, like I said, 2 3-point shots here early on. Definitely good for the junior Jordan Martin. That time, another turnover by the Knighttes, and that's been another thing that's kind of plagued the Knighttes this season, several turnovers from game to game.
Just silly turnovers.
Yeah,
honestly, it's nothing that you know, that you just can't, oh, you got to let that go. It's back-to-back. I mean, there's been a pattern that we've been noticing.
Well, and for several years here in the area, you had the girls that played very good fundamental basketball. And over the past couple of years, we've seen what I would call the girls almost playing like boys, and that's not meant to be a compliment. Usually when you hear a guy throwing like a girl, that's a little bit of an insult. In this case, playing like boys is a little bit of an insult because boys tend to play much faster and a lot looser basketball. They aren't real tight on the fundamentals all the time. They get a lot of bad shots off, and the girls here in the area starting to do a little bit of the same. Of course, it doesn't help when you've got a player as good as LeBron James kind of highlighting every single highlight reel that's played on ESPN every day. But high school players need to realize that not every single one of them could be a LeBron James. And sometimes that's a little bit hard to take, I guess. But Martin able to put another couple in, and that will tie her with Williams on the night, 8 points each for the junior and senior. Nearly a five-second inbound call there.
That's close.
Martin did a good job blocking any of the pass. Defense doing a great job here. Only 7 points for the Fredericktown Lady Cats. Nearly a travel there. Pulls it back out. Gets the shot up. It's no good off the back of the rim. And tipped out of bounds.
Been noticing a few close to those calls. Close calls on the traveling on both sides of the teams. You hate to blame everything on the refs, but
some of us do, some of us don't.
Oh,
being an official myself a little bit, I don't all the time, unless, of course, it's the finals of the Christmas tournament and we're playing against the Central Rebels, but I've talked about that enough this season.
No, we'll let that go. No, we won't.
Of course, we got our revenge a couple weeks ago in the finals of the conference tournament. We hope to do the same in the finals of this tournament.
Now we're up on them, so.
Yeah. Gillum bringing the ball down the court, another turnover, and instead Sweeney will turn the ball right back over to the Lady Cats.
It seems to be like most of the Knighettes get a little ahead of themselves.
Yeah, Sweeney tends to do that a little bit more often than what we would like to see. Right now, 3:47 left in the half. Knighttes have a pretty sizable lead, 15 points. Lady Cats not really able to do anything offensively so far.
As you said before on those outside shots, you know, if they're not going to be able to get past Williams this night, it's going to be a long one.
Yeah, and not only are they trying to take some of those outside shots, but, you know, the leader right now of the Lady Cats at 31, Tara Helm, who scored 23 points against us in their last game, has not been out on the court a ton here in the second half, just came in now, but she's got two fouls already, and she'll have to be very careful, because without Helm being in this game, Knighttes will have an easy, easy ride for the rest of the night.
As long as the shots keep falling the way that they are. Knighttes have a few decent shooters, including Williams on the outside. She's been known to pull a few up here and now and then.
Nash, with her second consecutive field goal for the Knighttes, puts them up 24-7 now. 17-point lead for the Knighttes. Gets the pass inside, back out, three-point range up. No good off the back of the rim once again. And Paul's with the rebound.
I don't know about you, but I find it reassuring to see so many young people on the Knighttes. Kind of gives you that, you know, good feeling. Caitlin Gillum with a three on the outside,
yep,
right there.
You're speaking just in time. Gillum hitting the three-point shot, and that's something that Fredericktown's been allowing Farmington to shoot a lot of those outside shots. And Farmington, who is relied heavily on their inside game, allowing those outside shots to be taken. The rebound and put back by Gillum. And Gillum on a run of her own now. 7 points for the sophomore.
We'll mark that down for Pauls as an assist.
Hey, Pauls came in a little bit too hard there, but a young player, district tournament. Of course, Katie Friend out ill tonight. So she's receiving a little bit more playing time. And we'll expect to see number 20 of the Knighettes, Alexis Pauls, out quite a bit as Friend recovers. Williams with the ball, 29-7. Currently the score, 22-point lead. Gillum trying to bring the ball in instead, receives the personal foul. That's by number 3, Annabeth Phillips. That's her first foul. That brings us to the one-on-one bonus at 7. Gillum with the chance from the line. She scored the first 2 points of the night from the line. Her first is up and in. And with that shot, Gillum is tied for leading score for the Knighettes. 3 Knighettes now with 8 points apiece. Gillum second, up and in. She takes the lead, 9 points now for the sophomore. Great job by Gillum so far.
Free throw is definitely a big game in the Knighettes, you know, right now, because a lot of teams don't seem to be able to get up on the Knights, and so you got to force those fouls half the time. And I don't know, free throws are just big right now for Knighettes.
Yeah, and Fredericktown's missed quite a few so far. You know, you pull in those that they've missed. I think that they've missed at this point 5 of their free throws. That's 14 points. Not saying that that puts them a ton closer to the 31 of the Knighettes, but definitely brings them a little bit more confidence when going back to the line for the rest of the night. Paul's fighting for the ball, and in the process ends up tripping up a Lady Cat there, so it'll be another foul on Paul's. That's her second. And Martin will spell the freshman for a little bit, trying to give her a little bit of a breather. And also bring in number 14 of the Knights, Elena Davis. Davis, also a freshman. This is the first time that she's getting a look at varsity action now, and especially in a game as big as this one. Fredericktown going around the perimeter, getting a three-point shot, no good. Pulls in the rebound just barely, her foot nearly on the line, 57 seconds left. Here in the opening half, gets the throw out, wide open baseline move, gets it off the glass, an easy couple of points there. And those 2 points put in, once again, pretty easily. Right down the baseline. 31-11 the score. 20-point lead for the Knighettes. 40 seconds on the clock. Knighettes will have an opportunity for at least one more shot. Gillum finally gets the pass off to Martin. Martin starts to take it down the middle. Gets the pass to Bader. Swatted out of her hands by the Lady Cats. Knighettes will have 29 seconds now to put another shot on the clock.
Knighettes definitely with the advantage most of the time with this height. You got Laura Lee Bader, Rachel Williams down low. That's a pretty big matchup that not most girl teams can handle. I mean, just normally whenever you don't think, oh, there's no opening there, that hand pops out.
Sweeney able to put her first couple of points on the board. And 11 seconds on the clock. Knighettes will try to put one more shot before the buzzer. Sweeney takes it down, puts it off the glass, rumbles around, nearly rebounded by Bader, tipped out of bounds, and we'll end this quarter with 0.3 seconds on the clock. We'll inbound here and end the quarter. That'll end the first half, 33-11. Knighettes able to triple the score of the Lady Cats here in the first quarter, and really, it all comes down to defense so far for the Knighettes. Knighettes doing a great job defensively, not letting the senior Helm be able to get in and attack them like she was able to during the conference tournament, 33-11. Hopefully, we'll see the same kind of result that we did when Farmington played Fredericktown the first time rather than the second time. Of course, the Knighettes did have this kind of lead in their second matchup there at the conference tournament, but we'll be right back with you after this halftime break on Black Knight Television. I'm Aaron Murray alongside with Carter Southern. Thank you for watching. And welcome back here for second half action of the district Semifinal game between the Farmington Knighettes and Fredericktown Lady Cats. Knighettes coming here into the second half with a sizable 22-point lead, 33-11. And, of course, you go back to just a couple of weeks ago, Knighettes had a pretty sizable lead in that one as well. That one shrank down in a hurry later on in the game, and Knighettes 2 seconds off the clock. First turnover already here in the second half. Jordan Martin taking a few steps before starting to dribble the ball.
Turnovers and rebounding, two big things that have already been an impact in this game.
Yeah, and Knighettes having some difficulty at times with the rebounds here and there during the year. Helm back out there for the Lady Cats. She's got two fouls, and that was a big story in the first half and a big reason why the Knighettes currently have that 22-point lead. And going into this game, we kind of speculate a little bit on what the Knighettes might do to take control of Helm. And we kind of guess that Williams could find herself guarding Helm all night long. And sure enough, that's been part of the case tonight. And Knighettes back-to-back turnovers now with not even 1 minute off the clock. Lady Cats setting up the play. It's over to the left side of the court. And instead, Knighettes defense holding tight. Not giving them Fredericktown any open looks. Open look that time. Pauls kind of got behind her.
Over a minute into this game in a scoreless half, and I take it back.
And the big story from couple weeks ago, sinking the three-point shot. Knighettes, two turnovers already. Chance here, Gillen charges in, and she could also have the first points of the second half for the Knighettes, same way that she did in the first. Both coming from the free throw line here. Gillen perfect from the line so far tonight. And her first shot.
You know you don't do that.
Off the front of the rim.
You know you don't do that. It's like saying, man, he's throwing a no-hitter.
It happens. Second shot is good. So once again, Gillen the leading scorer for the Knighettes tonight so far. And following her is Williams and Martin with 8 points apiece. Rebounded that time by Williams. Knighettes bringing the ball down the court. Gillen bringing it down. Tries to get the pass over to Williams. Williams not expecting the pass and nearly gets fouled in the process of trying to recover the turnover, but instead foul ends up being committed on Lexi Pauls, and that foul was called on Nicole Burns. Burns able to put a couple of free throws in early in the contest. Lady Cats, as we talked about during the break, Lady Cats for the first quarter and a half only had points from the free throw line. And a lot of that had to do with the fact that Helm had to be pulled out.
You can notice how they're really trying to set her out on the outside so far. I'd be doing the same thing too.
Williams standing strong on that one, trying to get the shot off, and instead not able to do so. And Martin tries to get the behind the back and the pass at the same time to Pauls, but Pauls are kind of pulled up there. So it'll be another turnover once again. Three turnovers early on here in the third quarter. Tipped out off the hands of number five, Paige Gotze. And Gotze having some trouble here in this district semifinal game. Gotze taking a few pretty poor shots. And another travel once again on the Knighettes. Make that four turnovers early on.
20 isn't that much of a difference.
Well, not if you're going to be committing four turnovers in just 2.5 minutes for the rest of the game.
That's what I've been preaching.
Repeat that for the rest of the game. And I don't like the look of things. You know, you think just in this quarter alone, if they were to continue on the pace that they are on right now, that's going to be, you know, you're looking at around 12, 14 turnovers just in this quarter alone if they continue on this pace. And if they do that over the next quarter and a half, they will be in some big trouble towards the end of the game if Helm can come on strong like she did in the conference tournament. But the Cats bring the ball down the court. Looks like getting fumbled a little bit, and it looks like the foul could be called on Gillum. Still waiting for the official call here. Instead, it's going to be called on number 20, Pauls. That's her third foul. It's the first team foul of the half. Knighettes nearly able to survive 3 minutes without their first team foul the second half. Sweeney will come in for the freshman Pauls. Williams doing a good job guarding the inbound. Helm is able to finally get it in. Helm being guarded closely by the senior Williams. Tries to bring it in, throws it back out. Pump fake, jumper up, no good, rebounded. And Bader gets the block shot. And as she follows through with the body, foul is called.
You hate to say things over and over again, but a lot of that stuff doesn't happen whenever you just, you know, box out and rebound how you're supposed to.
Tough foul call to receive after you've blocked the shot, but she did end up coming into her with the body on the block, so she wasn't able to just go straight up with the block. She had to come with a little bit of force, couldn't put the brakes on before making some contact. Able to put the second free throw in, one of two that time, and it'll be 34-15 to score, 19-point difference now. So they have been able to cut into this Knighettes lead just a little bit.
Starting to notice in the second half that Knighettes are just getting a little pressured, a little more than they're used to right now, and seeing a lot of the same lob passes. Not really smart decision-making on the Knighettes side so far.
Gillum with the ball gets it out to Williams, and the call is 3 seconds in the lane, and I believe that was on Bader. So another turnover by the Knighettes. Make that six turnovers now by the Knighettes. A three-point shot up and in by Godsey. Big three-point shot there. Cuts it back to 16 points. And a stupid foul that time. And you could hear several of the Fredericktown fans and saying the same exact thing. Just not the smartest foul right there. You had no reason. She wasn't doing anything with the ball. But, you know, when you start coming back like this, your adrenaline can pump a little bit. And you can make some bad decisions every now and then. And that was definitely one of them. Sweeney with the ball for the Knighettes. Sweeney having some trouble at times tonight. Couple of turnovers. Gillum with the ball now from Martin. Knighettes trying to get something set up out on the perimeter. Sweeney with the ball. Fakes it to the left and somehow able to get the shot off.
We'll take it.
We'll take it. No question there. So right now the Knighettes have the lead doubled. The Lady Cats score 18 points for 36-18.
That's some impressive math there.
I always kind of prided myself on that a little bit. Just under halfway through. Just over halfway through now here in the third quarter. The Lady Cats ball out of bounds. Gets the inbounds in. There's the two-handed soccer pass there. And puts the shot up, no good. Knighttes bringing the ball back down the other side of the court. Jordan with an open look, gets the shot in.
A little surprised there, you could tell.
Yeah.
Not really ready for that shot.
Fredericktown did not expect her to just pull up and shoot the jumper, but Jordan Martin having one of her best games of the season now. Includes a couple of three-point shots and a couple from field goal range.
Good look by Schneider.
She has a total of 10 points on the night. Nice job by Gillum, trying to get the shot off there, drawing another foul. She's been to the line quite a few times tonight. Gillum right now still the leading scorer.
Sweeney with an impressive pump fake there. It's amazing how effective those can be in these type of games.
And Gillum now has 11 points on the night. She was tied with Martin before that last free throw. Second shot is up and in. And nice job by Gillum. Total of 12 points on the night now. Helm with the ball for the Lady Cats.
Knighttes
have extended their lead back out to 22 points, same lead that they had going into the half.
Lady Cats definitely pushing the ball up pretty hard as they've been the second half, but it seems to be that they just can't capitalize on that speed and put the ball through down low.
If you look down there on the court, just a second ago, quite a bit of frustration on the face of Helm, as she cannot believe that she committed another turnover there, and she's pulled off. And with three fouls, she'll sit the bench, take a breather, and try to come back out in the fourth. Gillum with an open two-point look. No good off the back of the rim. Gillum, the leading scorer, trying to put another couple shots in. And Gillum putting a lot of pressure, full court press there, all the way down the court. And nearly able to force a turnover.
Don't know how much anybody will even care about this, but good to know. Alabama over Auburn right now, 23-16. In case anybody cares like as much as I do.
Well, if it was a tournament team, people would care. Anyway, 22-point difference still for the Knighttes. Just under 2 minutes left to go here in the third quarter. Talking about tournament teams, we can say a whole lot here in the state of Missouri about our main team, Mizzou, but you look just over the shoulder there, and a team that has had some hype over the past few years, SLU, getting quite a bit of hype this season. Mm-hmm. SLU, we can't remember what they went up to in the rankings, but they are a top 20 team right now in the AP poll.
Not too shabby.
Nash ends up with the turnover. Minute 30 on the clock. Gillum bringing the ball down the court for the Knighttes. Brings it right down the lane. And looked like she might have been trying to get the pass off to Nash, but probably be called a shooting foul here. So Gillum will go to the line for a couple. As I said, Gillum the leading scorer so far for the Knighttes. 12 points on the night.
A little more comfortable with Gillum on that foul line right now.
Gillum's definitely got the hot hand on the night from the free throw line. Misses the first one, though. That's only her second missed free throw on the night. Of course, the first one coming after I talked about how she had been perfect from the line all night. And her second is up and in. Make it 13 points now. 41-18 the score. 23-point lead for the Knighttes. Carter, we've talked about this a few times. Wasn't expecting tonight to be one of those nights necessarily. At the same time, kind of was. Looking back to the last matchup between the two teams, Fredericktown was able to make a comeback and make it a little bit of interesting and give us something to talk about. That's something that they're not being able to do this time. 41-18 the score. Knighttes have extended their lead by 1 point over the course of the quarter so far. Still got just over a minute left, and now we're inside the minute mark. Pass goes out to Sweeney. Sweeney spins around, gets it out to Gillum. Gillum brings it down to the corner to Martin. Martin with a three-point shot. It's up, no good, off the front of the rim.
Probably not the thrown. Best shot choice by Martin right there.
And ends up costing a couple of points, but not going to make a mountain out of the molehill there. It's 41-20 still, but the Knighttes will commit another turnover here. So depending on what happens here last 30 seconds, Lady Cats put a three-point shot up. It's back to being an 18-point difference. Definitely a large steep hill to climb if they're able to put the 3 points in here at the end of the quarter.
You know, just there's been crazier happen, but if Farmington keeps putting it in, and they need to start rebounding a little better, but shouldn't be too detrimental to the score.
Lady Cats unable to get the rebound there. Said tips it out of bounds, and 2 seconds left on the clock. Williams holds onto the ball. And we'll go into this final quarter with a 21-point lead by the Knighettes. We'll go ahead and take a break here real quick. Once again, Knighettes up 21 here on Black Knight Television. And welcome back for the fourth quarter. As I said, Knighettes with a sizable 21-point lead. So if the Lady Cats hope to come back in this one, they're going to have to do some quick shooting the ball. And so far, 15 seconds already off the clock. So taking quite a while to get these 2 points in, but they are able to do it thanks to number 22. And that's Brooke Tunjum with the points. 7:30 on the clock. And another foul committed, that one by 24. The Ellie Jensen with the foul. And it's set to inbound, get the inbound to Gillum. Gillum with the hot hand tonight. She's been pretty active, putting several points in, a total of 13 on the night, en route to the 41 for the Knighettes. Ball's in the corner, tries to get the pass across, gets it to Williams. Williams with the short jumper, puts it in 4-2.
Most of which coming from free throws, might I add.
Surprisingly, that's Williams' first shot of the second half. She scored 8 in the first, now 10 total on the night.
A little quiet tonight.
And Williams, now Williams actually has been quiet her past couple of games. That game against Fredericktown, she was held pretty quiet that night. And then in the next game against North County, Jordan Martin was actually the leading scorer in that one with a couple of three-point shots. And that was something that she was definitely pretty proud of, leading the team that night to a victory after the disappointing night against Fredericktown. And just as I'm talking about her, put another 3 points up on the board. That's her third three-point shot of the night, and that's 13 points for the junior. That's her highest total of the season. And as the shots put up there, Bader comes across and ends up committing the foul. Several of the Knighettes kind of laughing about that one after committing the foul.
And the shot by number 22 on the Lady Cats side is good.
Yeah, Tunjum is the 5'11 senior for the Lady Cats. She's one of a couple of seniors on the court right now. Shall I make that 3 seniors on the court? Oh, just the 2. You got Helm out there. Burns right now is currently on the bench, but she's been playing quite a bit tonight. Williams with the putback that time, and after staying scoreless during the third quarter, already has 4 points here in the fourth quarter.
You'll notice on the Lady Cat side that there's no juniors. Just a few seniors and a lot of young sophomores and freshmen on their side.
Yeah, I haven't really noticed that. A lot of youth on the team. Of course, the leading scorer, Tara Helm, will be graduating this year, but
that'll
we will
big.
Also be graduating our leading scorer of the season. Senior Rachel Williams will go on to play volleyball in college, signed earlier this school year. But the Knighettes will still have quite a bit of talent. We've got some youth out there, and one of those just put a couple points on the board. Laura Lee Bader only with 4 points tonight, so she's been pretty quiet. A few fouls here and there. Helm with the long look. It's no good. Rebounded by Williams. Williams starts to bring it down over to Martin. Martin wanting to put the move on Helm instead. Gets it off the glass. It's no good. Rebounded by Martin. Martin spins around. Gets it out to Gillum. Knighettes with a few smiles on their faces. And that time a bad pass by Pauls.
I guess you can get a little more relaxed whenever you got such a lead. But you'll see a lot of that. And I don't know. That's just kind of what bothers me, I guess, about girls basketball. But I won't go too in-depth about that.
27-point difference right now. So, yeah, you could be a little bit relaxed, but especially on the young Pauls, you want to make sure and try to make a statement here in the tournament. And statement that she just made now, instead, actually, it looks like that foul is going to be called on Gillum. Thought the foul was going to be called on Pauls, and I'm pretty sure that would have been her fourth foul. So Pauls got lucky that time getting the foul called on Gillum instead of herself. Helm with the ball, gets an open look up at the top of the key. It's off front of the rim and the board, no good. Williams ends up with another rebound, gets a pass down to Bader. Bader with a short jumper, it's off the backboard, no good. Gets a tip, no good once again. And looks like might have had a little bit of an over-the-back call and started to grab the rebound and might have even slammed the ball down a little bit at the same time.
Not so sure whether that was an accident or not.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. Tried to figure it out. Coach Mack pulled her over there to the side and talked to her for a little bit. She walked away with a smile. So I'm going to guess that a little bit that could have been slightly on purpose, but Coach went ahead and made sure to talk to her before the referee got to her.
I guess we're just a little unsure about that 1-1 call there.
An odd 1-1 rebound that time. The rebound pulled in by Williams. Sweeney with the 3-point look.
With the follow?
It's no good. Tried to come in for the rebound, but it is rebounded by the Lady Cats. They'll bring it back down the court. It's definitely been an odd second half here. Lady Cats trying everything they can to put some points on the board, and Knightheads playing a little bit loose with the ball. But they've been able to add to their lead throughout the half. 27-point lead, 50-23, still the score here in the fourth quarter. And we're just at 4:09 now as the ball is kicked out of bounds by Tonjum. Williams with the inbounds. Gets the inbounds pass to Gillum. Gillum pulls back off the board, no good. And Pauls with the steal this time. Tries to get the pass down to Sweeney, does. And as Sweeney tries to make the move to try to get the shot in, Tonjum hits the floor with quite a bit of force. And
to be honest, I thought that was the wrong call. I thought we were going to get a travel there after the call it ball.
Yeah, she
jump stop.
She moved a little bit, but big thing was is she was able to draw a Tonjum up in the air, and it was one of those NBA fouls, kind of. And it's one of those fouls that, you know, you got them to draw off a little bit. And once her body was up in the air, Sweeney made sure to take advantage and draw the foul. Gillum with the inbounds, gets it into Williams. Williams pulls it down the lane, gets the shot off, and puts it in with the she'll get a chance to go to the line for one more. And it's number 12, Burns, with her fifth foul, and you'll be able to see here in just a second on your TVs at home, not too happy with herself. This is going to be her last game. She is one of the seniors.
Oh, you never want to end a season like that, you know. Fredericktown with a three there. By number three, Phillips. And a freshman for Fredericktown.
Freshman coming in, trying to put a little bit of energy into these Lady Cats. Bader with the travel there. Bad move by Bader. She would have just taken the time to dribble the ball.
That just seems to be a lot of the unfundamental things that I see.
Yeah, and Bader's had a few issues with some of the fundamentals this season. Overall, been a player that has shown some hope for the future, but she'll have to take care of a few of those things when she becomes the main player in the post position with Williams graduating. Just over 3 minutes on the clock. Knighttes still with the 28-point lead. Paul spins around, trying to get a look inside to Gillum. Gillum off the glass and in.
I won't be too surprised if we see Gillum kind of taking that spot as well. I don't think she's recognized for, you know, really how tall she is.
Williams, the leading scorer on the night with 18 points. That happened in a hurry here in the fourth quarter as she kind of took charge. Gillum had it for a while. Gillum able to put 2 points in just a second ago. And that actually takes Gillum up to a total of 15, so she's just close behind. But the big story on the night also is Jordan Martin, who's able to put 13 points in with 3 3-point shots. Pauls takes it all the way down and ends up drawing the foul in the process. She'll go to the line.
4-2. Clock. 2 minutes left in this game.
Yep, 30-point lead for the Knighettes now.
Safe to say this game's about over.
The running clock. Pauls gets it off the back of the rim. No good. It was that last 2 points by Gillum that pushed it into the running clock. And now here at the very end, Knighettes will put their subs in. Sounded like the last time that these two teams matched up. Coach Mack was a little bit quick to pull the trigger, put the subs in during the third quarter this time, making sure to leave the starters in for as long as possible. And the block call is made. Looks like the foul will be on Nash. Nash hit the floor pretty hard.
You just hear hush. You don't know whether to laugh or...
She got up smiling a little bit. Not exactly what I expected after she laid on the court for a little bit. But
I'm the horrible person that wants to laugh about those things.
Glad to know that she's all right. Well, she was laughing about it herself, so you can't feel too bad about it. 107 on the clock. Pulled out of the running clock now, 56-27 with that first free throw. Second free throw shot is up and in for the Lady Cats. So they'll take that lead. Knighettes right now still have the score of the Lady Cats doubled. And we've talked about that a few times tonight. Of course, had the score tripled and several times doubled in the game. And right now it's doubled 28-56, 52 seconds left on the clock. Lady Cats bring the ball down the court. And as I said, this will be the last time for some of the seniors from Fredericktown to have a chance to call themselves basketball Lady Cats. Martin with a nice behind-the-back move after the three-point shot by the freshman Phillips, who sank for the Lady Cats. Nash trying to put it in and lets it go out of bounds.
That shows you how much this game, you know, they care about right now.
And Nash didn't care to try to grab the ball. She just let it go out of bounds, let a little bit more time drain off the clock, which is definitely appropriate. Gets the pass into Savage there. Savage spins it around, puts it off the glass and in. And that's the first time Savage has put points on the board tonight. She just came into the game a bit ago as one of those subs. Another three look from number three. Nash gets the rebound with 7 seconds on the clock. Pauls fumbles the basketball around a little bit, picks it up and rolls around at the same time. So it was kind of some schoolyard ending to that game, but Knighettes able to finish this one off, thankfully. 27-point difference. They're able to actually do even better than what they did in their first matchup against the Lady Cats. So Knighettes will take this big win into the finals of the district tournament. Of course, we do not know who they will play. That's going to be decided in just a bit. Two teams up next to play, North County Lady Raiders and the Central Lady Rebels. That'll be a big one to watch. But we'll see exactly what happens there online, and then we'll be back with you Friday night as the Knighettes will play one of those two, and we expect Farmington and Central to meet up for the fourth time this season on the boys' side. Once again, bringing you tonight's game, Aaron Murray alongside with Carter Southern. Thank you for watching here on Black Knight Television.